Here we want to solve sine 2x equals 2 cosine squared x on the given interval. Now even though we are going to solve this equation on this interval, we'll also review how to express all solutions to this equation. So there's a couple things going on in this equation. First, we have two different trig functions, which sometimes isn't good. But the main thing here is that one of the angles is 2x and the other angle is x. So we'll have to replace the left side of this equation, sine 2x, using the double angle identity for sine, as we see here below. So we're going to replace sine 2x with 2 sine x cosine x. And hopefully that's going to make this easier to solve. So again, the left side is going to be 2 sine x times cosine x equals 2 cosine squared x. Normally it's best to have a trig equation in terms of one trig function, but notice how both of these terms do have a factor of cosine, so it will factor. So let's go ahead and set this equal to 0 and then factor. It doesn't matter which term we subtract. I'm going to go ahead and subtract 2 sine x cosine x on both sides. So on the left side, this would be 0. On the right side, we'll have 2 cosine squared x minus 2 sine x cosine x. Now both of these terms have a factor of 2 as well as a factor of cosine x. So let's factor out 2 cosine x. We're left with cosine x minus sine x. So if this product is equal to 0, then either 2 cosine x equals 0 or cosine x minus sine x is equal to 0. Where if we divide both sides by 2, we're still going to have cosine x equals 0. So we can solve for x by determining which angles have a cosine function value of 0 on the given interval. This equation here is a little bit more interesting. Let's go ahead and add sine x to both sides. That would give us cosine x equals sine x. And now if we divide both sides by cosine x, the left side, cosine x divided by cosine x is equal to 1. Then remember, sine x divided by cosine x is equal to tangent x. So we're looking for angles where the tangent function value is equal to 1 and where the cosine function value is equal to 0. Let's go and determine those function values using the unit circle. On the unit circle, cosine theta is equal to x. So to determine where cosine x is equal to 0, we need to identify points on the unit circle where the x-coordinate is equal to 0. And that occurs here and here, which means if an angle is in standard position and the terminal side intersects the unit circle at these points, it would satisfy this equation. And since we want solutions on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, one angle would be pi over 2 radians. And the other angle would have a terminal side here, so we'd be at 3 pi over 2 radians. Now let's talk about where tangent x is equal to 1. On the unit circle, tangent theta is equal to y divided by x, which means both the x and the y coordinates would have to be the same to have a tangent function value of positive 1. Notice at pi over 4 radians, the x and y coordinates are equal, as well as 5 pi over 4 radians, where both x and y coordinates are negative, which means any angle in standard position passing through these two points would also satisfy the equation. So in the given interval, we have pi over 4 radians here, as well as 5 pi over 4 radians here. I also mentioned I would review how to express all solutions to an equation like this. So to express all solutions where cosine x is equal to 0, remember we had initial side here and the terminal sides were here and here. Notice how these solutions are pi radians apart. So one way to express all the solutions where cosine x is equal to 0 would be x equals one of these solutions, pi over 2 radians, plus multiples of pi, or to say pi times k, where k is some integer, meaning k is 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2.
And so on.
Then looking at where tangent x is equal to 1, notice how these two angles as well are pi radians apart. Here's pi over 4 radians, and here's 5 pi over 4 radians. So again, a way to express all solutions where tangent x is equal to 1 would be x equals one of the angles, pi over 4 radians, plus multiples of pi radians. So pi times k, again, where k is some integer. But for this problem, we're only asked to solve on this interval. Therefore, we have four solutions, two here and two here. Let's go ahead and write those back on the previous screen. We had x equals pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. And then we also had x equals pi over 4 and 5 pi over 4. I hope you found this helpful.